हेलो चिल्ड्रंस, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन माय केमिस्ट्री ऑनलाइन क्लास। चिल्ड्रंस, आई होप दैट योर स्टडी इज गोइंग इन ए पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन एंड यू आर कंप्लीटिंग योर नोट्स एंड डूइंग न्यूमेरिकल्स प्रॉपरली। Students, in the continuation of the same chapter, that is some basic concept of chemistry. In today's lecture, we are going to study a new point, that is limiting reagent or limiting reactant. Alright. But students, before starting this point, I want to discuss with you one question of your NCERT book concerned to empirical formula is given on page number 22 and the question number is 1.3. So how it will be, how the empirical formula of this very question can be calculated. So students, as you are knowing, I am providing you best and simple way by which you can solve the problems very easily and accurately. Question. So let's start. The question is, determine the empirical formula of an oxide of iron which has 69.9% iron and 30.1% oxygen by mass. So students, on the basis of given data of the question, we have to determine what will be the empirical formula of oxide of iron. Okay, so as you are watching here, the percentage of oxygen given is 69.9% and that of oxygen is 30.1%. Students, I have already taught you about percentage. Percentage means the value must be equal to 100, and here the percentage of iron and percentage of oxygen, if you add, this value is coming exactly equal to 100%. Means in the oxide of iron, only two elements, iron and oxygen, are present. No other element is present in that compound. Alright. So students, as I have taught you, for the determination of empirical formula, you have to construct a table by which you can easily determine the empirical formula of compound. So, in first column, write symbol of elements. Suppose E stand for element. Second column is of percentage, next column is of atomic mass of the element, okay. Third column, as you are knowing, is of relative ratio or atomic mass or moles of the element showing the relative ratio. And next column is of simple ratio, which is also termed molar ratio of the elements. Okay, so on constructing this table and put the values, so element presents are here iron and oxygen, two elements are present here, their percentage are known. So iron is 69.9 and oxygen is 30.1. Atomic mass of iron is what? That is 56. And atomic mass of oxygen is what? That is 16. And student, as usual, for getting relative ratio, we have to divide given percentage by atomic mass. So divide here 69.9 by 56 and here 30.1 by 16. So on division, this value approximately will come 1.25. 69.9 to 56 1.25. And this 30.1, if you divide, so that is 16, one time it is going, so this is nearly about 1.88. And now, students, what you have to do here? Now select the list value which is present in these two. So in these two, list value is 1.5. So divide by 1.5 to each for getting the simplest ratio. Am I right, students? So go in the same way. That is, divide for getting simplest ratio. 1.25 divided by 1.25. And here 1.88 divided to 1.25. This value is coming exactly 1. Alright? And students, this can be written as 1.88 divided by 1.25. This may be written as 188 upon 125. Okay? So that is what? That is nearly equal to 1.5. 125 divided by 188, nearly it will come 1.5. So this value is coming 1.5. So students, in simplest ratio or simple ratio, one value is coming in a decimal or fraction. So for such type of problems, you have to convert this decimal or fraction by multiplying a whole number in order to get that is simple ratio. Means here is 1.5. If these two numbers are multiplied by 2, why we are multiplying? Multiplication is taking place. If any value is coming of simple ratio in fraction or decimal, then in order to get a whole number ratio, that is multiplied by a suitable factor. Alright? So suppose this one is multiplied by 2 and this is also multiplied by 2. Okay? So this is coming, children, 1 into 2 is 2 and 1.5 into 2 is 3. Alright? So simple ratio of the elements which are present in oxide of iron are coming 2 and 3. Means there are 2 atoms of iron and oxygen, and their simple ratio is coming in the order of 2:3. And as you are knowing that, in order to express the empirical formula of the compound, the ratio which are coming is written to the right hand corner left of the symbol of that element, and then you will get the empirical formula of the compound. So empirical formula of the compound will be Fi. First is Fi, and their ratio is, simplest ratio is 2. So write this value 2 to the right of this iron symbol and below, that is Fi 2. And similarly, ratio of oxygen is 3. So write here Fi 2. So the empirical formula of the oxide of iron will be Fe2O3, and you are knowing Fe2O3 is what? It is an oxide of iron, and chemically it is called ferric oxide, and it is called
ferric oxide. All right, it is. So by this manner, you can easily find out the empirical formula of the compound on the basis of available data. All right, is it? In continuation of the same question, one question is also given in your NCERT book. That is question number 1.8. Question number 1.8 on same page. And in that, on the same data, you have to find the molecular formula of the oxide of iron. According to the question concerned to the same, one question, that is your question number 1.8 of your exercise book, in which on the same data which is given in this question, they are asking what will be the, how you will find the molecular formula of the compound. So children, very simply, you can find the molecular formula of compound by using the formula which I have taught you earlier during the lecture of relationship between empirical formula and molecular formula of the compound. So, as you are knowing that molecular formula of the compound is equals to N into empirical formula of the compound. Am I clear, students? Molecular formula is equal to N into empirical formula. And the empirical formula you are just finding Fe2O3. And asking in the question is, what is the molecular formula of the oxide of iron? So, molecular formula will be N into, just you have determined empirical formula. So, right here Fe2O3. And one point must remember, children, that this value N is what you are saying there. Its value is a positive value, having value 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. But in this case, must remember, in the empirical formula of Fe2O3, none of the element having a common factor, means iron is 2 and oxygen is 3, means none is common there. So in that case, where in the empirical formula of the compound, the ratio of the atoms of the elements are not common, means there is no common factor, then in that case, the value of N is always considered as 1 only. Alright? So, in this case, there is no common factor in Fe2O3. This is Fe2, this is 2Fe, this is 3O. There is no common factor. So, the value of N will be N into Fe2O3, and that is Fe2O3. Means, the empirical formula of the compound will be just equals to the molecular formula of the compound. So must remember why we are writing here 1. So in the case where there is no common factor, then in that case the value of N is always considered as a 1. So here 1 is written. If you are not understanding, suppose I am taking, that is Fe2O3. Children, try to understand, this is Fe2O3. Suppose in order to make it a simple whole number, suppose it is multiplied by 2. So by multiplying 2, what it becomes? It becomes Fe4 into O6. And still in this also, there is no common factor. There is no common factor. If you are taking common factor as 2, still this will come Fe2O3. So in that case, where the common factor is not present there, means common factor is not in the concerned compound, then in that case the value of N is always taken
as 1.
So molecular formula of the oxide of iron according to the data available in the question will be, that is Fe2O3, means the empirical formula and molecular formula of the compound will be same. Alright, isn't it? Now come on the main point. And one thing I want to tell you, that try to solve much and much numericals which are given in your book, then your fundamental concept become clear and you will be in position to solve any type of question. Okay, student, I think now you will do and you can do very well mannered. Now come on the topic that is we have to discuss, that is what is limiting reagent or limiting reactant. So students, as the name of the point, limiting reagent is also called a limiting reactant. What is the meaning of this point? So children, limiting reagent or limiting reactant means that in a chemical reaction, one reactant is always in excess over the other reactant or other reagent. Means if one reactant is present in a excess amount, then other must be present in a lesser amount. That is the meaning of limiting reagent. Once again I am repeating this point. What the means of limiting reagent or limiting reactant? Must remember, in a chemical reaction, one reactant or one reagent is always present in excess over the other reactant or reagent which is present in the chemical reaction. And the reactant which is present in lesser amount in the chemical reaction is called or known as the limiting reagent or limiting reactant of that very reaction. Clear, children? And this limiting reactant or limiting reagent may be defined as the reactant or reagent which gets consumed in a chemical reaction and whose amount limits the amount of product formed in a chemical reaction is called limiting reagent or limiting reactant. For example, in the combustion reaction of methane, that is CH4, in gaseous state reacts with oxygen in gaseous state, giving rise to the formation of carbon dioxide in gaseous state and 2H2O in gaseous state. So this reaction represents the combustion reaction of methane. And combustion means the burning of hydrocarbon in presence of air or with oxygen, called combustion reaction. This is the point. Combustion reaction. Okay, student? So in this very reaction, the methane CH4 present in a lesser amount than oxygen. So in that case, there are two reactants or two reagents, that is methane and oxygen. So methane is present in a lesser amount in comparison to oxygen. So for this very reaction, this methane will be the limiting reagent or limiting reactant for the chemical reaction or combustion reaction of methane. And one more point, children. The product formed, the amount of product formed during this chemical reaction depends upon the amount of methane, means that is limiting reagent, not on oxygen. Not on oxygen, because oxygen is always present
in excess amount in comparison to methane. And that can, this point can also be explained better by using a data concerned to mathematical expression. So mathematically, the amount of methane and amount of oxygen can be calculated, and on calculation by mathematical calculation, you will find that the amount of methane will come lesser in comparison to this oxygen. So that's why this methane will be the limiting reagent for this reaction. One more example I providing you. Suppose one reaction, that is when nitrogen reacts with hydrogen under the gaseous condition, resulting the formation of ammonia gas. So in this reaction, chemical reaction students, this formed hydrogen will be the limiting reagent for this reaction, because this limits the formation of ammonia, and the formation of ammonia for amount of formation of products depends upon hydrogen, not on nitrogen. So far in this reaction, hydrogen will be the limiting reagent for this very reaction. So this is the term limiting reagent or limiting reactant, must remember. And student, if have any doubt, any confusion, ask me without any hesitation. I always available for you. And student, one thing I want to tell you, if I am providing you our best, then I think you will also do your best. So students, that's all today. In next lecture, we will discuss the next point of the chapter. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.